There is only one God, La ilaha illallah. Lord above the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what, and why. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah. I've seen the perfection of all creation in every creature and leaf. And I don't understand any woman or man who denies the one true belief. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah.
Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh. Wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyi'ati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lah. Wa man yudlil fala hadiya lah. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. And welcome again to the best of stories from the Quran. The last episode, we talked about the process of the creation of Adam عليه السلام, until Adam finally came into existence when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala breathed the soul into him. Brothers and sisters in Islam, before we carry on talking about what happened to Adam afterwards, there are some things that I need to share with you. I was unable, the last episode, to bring the idea of the importance of the soul across to you because of the time. I mentioned in the last episode that Adam alayhi salam, without the soul, he was just a piece of dirt, simply. The soul is what gives you life. And this is something that a lot of people are unaware of, brothers and sisters in Islam, that the soul needs nutrition exactly like the body. For example, in order to nourish your body, you eat, you drink. That is how you keep that body alive. But what you need to understand, brothers and sisters in Islam, that your soul also needs nourishment. And you know what is the nourishment of the soul? Is the guidance, is Islam, is submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. في صحيح البخاري حديث أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله عنه قال صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, مثل الذي يذكر ربه والذي لا يذكر ربه كمثل الحي والميت. The likeness of the person who remembers Allah, who submits to Allah and establishes the salah, pays the zakah, fasts, and does all the acts of worship. And the one who does not is like the living and the dead. The hadith here, brothers and sisters in Islam, is not talking about the life of the body. No, the hadith is talking about the life of the soul that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala breathed in you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, addressing the believers, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَجِيبُوا لِلَّهِ وَلِلرَّسُولِ إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ. O ye who believe, respond to Allah, respond to the Messenger, implement what they commanded you, because this will give you life. Take care of your souls, brothers and sisters in Islam. You can eat as much as you want, but this will not get to the soul. You can drink as much as you want, but this is not going to nourish the soul. What will nourish the soul is salah, is zakah, is fasting, recitation of the Quran, pondering upon the Quran, acting righteously, enjoining good, forbidding evil, being dutiful to the parents, and on and on and on, brothers and sisters in Islam. Very quickly, before I move on, Be aware that Satan, the enemy, the sworn enemy of the human race, of the human beings, has already introduced some substance into this world which can help your souls for a little while. But it had these substance, they have devastating consequences or side effects. You know what I'm talking about? I'm talking about alcohol. That is why they call it spiritual drinks. Yes, it makes you high for a while, but it will destroy you at the end. I'm talking about drugs, marijuana. I'm talking about substance such as heroin, cocaine, max, all that stuff was the introduction, was the invention of shaitan, of Satan. It helps your soul for a little bit, but it will destroy you. Like the, you heard about that mad cow disease. You know why these cows ended up with the mad cow disease? You know why? Because they were feeding them chemicals. The wrong substance, the same exact thing. If you nourish that soul with the wrong substance, you're going to end up with a mad cow disease. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the second thing, before I carry on talking about Adam, there is a hadith out there that a lot of Muslims are confused about, which is what? إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَلَقَ آدَمَ عَلَى صُورَتِهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam on his shape. They actually understand this hadith based on what? Some of the understanding of the people of the book, that our shape is the shape of Allah. Subhanallah. Have we seen Allah? We cannot say that. No. What is meant in this hadith, brothers and sisters in Islam, and the hadith is Sahih Muslim, the hadith is authentic. But you need to understand, this is the understanding of the people of the book in the Old Testament. That's what they teach, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has our shape. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam on his shape. That means what? Adam did not go the stages that we go through as his offspring. Adam was created on his adult form, the actual form. Adam was fashioned, molded, and then stood up. So that was his shape, which is 60 dirah, 60 arm length, and so on. So, but Adam alayhi salam did not go through the stages of creation, and that is what is meant in this hadith. Number three, the overwhelming power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once it comes to creation. Look at this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam without a father or a mother. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created his wife from Adam, meaning from a father. We know Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi Sahih Muslim told us that إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَلَقَ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the mate of Adam, Hawa, from Dalla, from a rib. So then the wife of Adam was created from Adam, meaning from a father and not from a mother. Look, Prophet Isa alayhi salam was created from a mother without a father. And me and you, we are made from a father and a mother. إِنَّمَا أَمْرُهُ إِذَا أَرَادَ شَيْئًا أَنْ يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. This is the Lord that you worship. He's able to do everything. And that is why the Christians, they say that Allah has a son. Why? Why Allah has a son, Yasidi? Because they tell you that Isa did not have a father. What about Adam?
إِنَّ مَثَلَ عِيسَى عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ آدَمَ خلقه من تراب ثم قال له كن فيكون.
Indeed, the likeness of Isa عليه السلام with Allah is like Adam. He created him from clay and he commanded him to be, so he was. Brothers and sisters in Islam, another thing before we carry on, there is a beautiful hadith في مسند الإمام أحمد, حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was going through the process of the creation of Adam, which is water, then clay, then mud, and on and on and on, Iblis, Satan was there already. And we know, we're going to find out that Satan has already a sworn animosity with us. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that Satan kept going around Adam. When he was just clay, laying down in the ground, laying down, he's not a human being yet. No soul in him yet. Allah did not breathe the soul in him yet. And then he found out that Adam has a lot of hollows, a lot of holes inside. And then he said, إِنَّ هَذَا خَلْقٌ لَا يَتَمَاسَكُ. It will be an easy to deceive and easy to basically take astray. But Satan was not aware that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will breathe into him his soul. And that is what gives you strength in fighting Satan. Brothers and sisters in Islam, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam and he breathed the soul in him, and this hadith fi Sahih ibn Hibban min hadith Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala breathed the soul in Adam, the soul went through his head, then he sneezed. Adam sneezed. And he immediately said, Alhamdulillah. You know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Adam? He told him, Yarhamukallah. Ya Allah. Can you imagine? Subhanallah. The first thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told our Adam, I will have mercy on you. Allah actually subhanahu wa ta'ala made dua, yarhamukallah. And actually it became, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam actually made it a right of a Muslim upon another Muslim. Kama fi sahih Muslim, hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned 6 rights of the Muslim upon another Muslims. One of them is tashmitul atis. If your brother in Islam sneezes and he says alhamdulillah, it is a right upon you to tell your brother yarhamukallah, and then you answer him by saying yahdikumullahu wa yuslih balakum. But shahid from this hadith that here is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Adam alayhi salam yarhamukallah. This is how much merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us, brothers and sisters in Islam. Huwa rahim, yani subhanallah. People, the children of Adam, who belie Allah, deny Allah, disbelieve in Allah, and he still provides for them. He still provides for them. Huwa rahmanu dunya. He is all merciful. He is all merciful to the people in this world. Yani, disbelievers, he still give them good health. Disbelievers in him, he still provides for them food and everything. He is so merciful with us, brothers and sisters in Islam. But he will be more merciful with the believers, and he will be the Rahim, the compassionate to the believers in the day of resurrection. Brothers and sisters in Islam, also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Adam alayhi salam, and this hadith fi Musnad Abi Ya'la, beautiful hadith that I will share with you, commanded Adam to go and say to the angels after he stood up, go and say to the angels, Assalamu alaykum. Can you imagine? So the first two words that came out of the mouth of Adam is what? Alhamdulillah and peace. All praise be to Allah for creating me. Say Alhamdulillah. Be grateful. Number two is Assalamu alaykum. Adam went to the angels and he told them, Assalamu alaykum. The angels answered by saying, Wa alaykum assalamu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Huh? Then Adam returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he told him, Oh Allah, they told me, I told them, Assalamu alaykum, and Allah knows best what happened. And they told me, Wa alaykum assalamu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Adam alayhi salam, this will be the greeting of your offspring. Your greeting and the greeting of your offspring. And it will be the greeting of those who will go to Jannah as well. Peace, peace, peace. Brothers and sisters in Islam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Adam that this will be the greeting of your offspring, Adam asked, Who is my offspring? Allah will answer him. Let's take a short break and come back and find out what did Allah told Adam. What did Allah tell Adam alayhi salam? We'll take a short break and come back. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
There is only one God, La ilaha illallah. Lord above the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what and why. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah.
Women around the Prophet. What do you know about women in Islam? Do you know the role that women played in Islamic history? Sheikh Ismail Rafai will relate the stories of the Prophet's wives in the program, Women Around the Prophet.
Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, may Allah be pleased with him, the person he decided that this Quran should stay with and be left with was none other than our mother Hafsa bint al-Khattab. So this whole Quran was left with her. This is a great trust. Khadija bint Khuwaylid. She is أفقه نساء الأمة. She's the most knowledgeable of this ummah, because she is my mother, your mother, and the mother of all the believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Women around the Prophet in Ramadan on Huda TV.
There is only one God, La ilaha illallah. Lord above the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what and why. There is only one God, La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome again to the best of stories, brothers and sisters in Islam. Before the break, we talked about the greeting of Adam, which is Assalamu alaikum. And this is the greeting of the Muslims. And also Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Hadith Abi Huraira that I mentioned earlier for Sahih Muslim, he made it actually one of the rights upon another Muslim, that if a Muslim tells you Assalamu alaikum, that you must say Wa alaikum salam to that person. And subhanAllah, if you say Assalamu alaikum, then you get 10 hasana. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, you make 20 hasana. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, you make 30 hasana. Just like that, just by saying salam. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that afshu salam baynakum, spread salam amongst you. And he said, kama fi sahih al-Bukhari hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, by Allah, you will not enter Jannah unless you believe. And you will not be able to, you will not attain iman, faith, unless you love one another. Shall I tell you about something that if you do, you will love one another? Afshu salam baynakum, spread salam amongst you. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought up and we're quoting hadith fi Musnad Abi Ya'la al-Mawsili rahimahullah, and the hadith is hasan, is good chain of narration, and the hadith also has another wording with Ibn Abbas fi al-Musnad and others. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Adam alayhi salam about his offspring, Adam asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who are my offspring, O Allah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala masaha ala dhahrihi, wiped on his back, and then he brought out of his back every single human being who will exist. I'm talking about you and me, who will exist as the offspring of Adam. قال الله تعالى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said,
وَإِذْ أَخَذَ رَبُّكَ مِنْ بَنِي آدَمَ مِنْ ظُهُورِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ وَأَشْهَدَهُمْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَىٰ شَهِدْنَا.
Remember when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took from the backs of Adam, the back of Adam, all his offspring, and he asked us, by the way, am I your Lord? By the way, this happened to all of us. We don't remember it, but this is something that happened. Am I your Lord? We answered and we said, Bala, yes, O Allah, you are our Lord. But because we may end up forgetting this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was merciful to us. It would have been sufficient. That covenant, this is what the scholars call ميثاق العبودية, a covenant of servitude to Allah, that you're going to be a slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This would have been sufficient for us as an evidence, as a hujjah against us. But because, كما يقول ابن عباس, as ابن عباس said, إنما سمي الإنسان, the insan was called insan because he forgets. We forgot that covenant. We forgot that we said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the time when Allah brought out of Adam all his offspring, that you are our Lord and we're going to worship you and we will not set rivals in worship with you. And this is, by the way, is the state of origin, the pure state of the human being. What is meant fi hadith al-Bukhari, hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كُلُّ مَوْلُودٍ يُولَدُ عَلَى الْفِطْرَةِ. Every newborn is born a Muslim. That is what is meaning by the word al-fitrah. This is the fitrah. This is the covenant of servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then what happened? فَأَذَوَاهُ. Then the parents will do that. يُهَوِّدَانِ. They will turn him into a Jew.
أو ينصراني, they will turn him into a Christian, أو يمجساني, or then they will turn him to another faith or another religion out there. And that is why, by the way, subhanAllah, the brothers and the sisters in the West, once they become Muslims, they refuse to be called converts or converts. They use the verb reverts, because they just went back, because a convert is somebody. No, they were born Muslims, but they just went back to their original state, the state on which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fashioned everybody, fashioned us, which is a state of Islam. In this hadith also, brothers and sisters in Islam, it stresses the overwhelming responsibility of the parents. Look, in this hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala delivers to you a Muslim, a baby Muslim, a Muslim baby. Whether you are a Christian or a Jew, whether you are, look at your job, or a Muslim, look at your job. Your job or your mission is to make sure that you make sure that child grows up as a Muslim, stays as a Muslim. He or she does not go astray. Another interesting thing happened, and I know it's a little bit off track from the story of Adam, but it's really, I cannot pass by without mentioning it. When Adam alayhi salam looked at his offspring, he found a very shiny man. Very رجل له وميض. This is the hadith. And he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, who's this? Who's this man? He said, هذا ولد سبحانه وتعالى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, هذا ولدك داود. This is your son داود. And he will come at the end of time. Subhanallah, داود, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, will come at the end of time. Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rab, kam umru? How old will he live? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Adam alayhi salam, 60 years. Sayyidina Adam said, oh Allah, only 60 years. Then Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rab, oh Allah, take from my time 40 and make him live 100 years. So Sayyidina Adam wanted his offspring, his son, Dawood, to live 100 years. So basically, take away from my life, Sayyidina Adam was to live 1,000 years, based on the hadith. So now, Sayyidina Adam is going to end up living 960 years instead of 1,000 years. And we know that the prophets and they normally, the angel of death comes and he informs them about their death. So when the angel of death came to Adam alayhi salam to take his soul, he told them, I'm supposed to live 1,000 years. And then the angel of death reminded Adam alayhi salam, saying, remember, you gave 40 years to your son Dawood. And then Adam said, no, I did not. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, فَجَحَدَ آدَمْ وَجَحَدَتْ ذُرِّيَّتُهُ فَنَسِيَ آدَمْ وَنَسِيَتْ ذُرِّيَّتُهُ. Adam forgot what he have already vowed to do or promised to do. And the offspring of Adam will be likewise. They forget. We forget. We forget. We make promises and we forget. We make promises and we forget. Subhanallah, Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, just to let you know the fiqh, the understanding of Ibn Kathir of the Quran. You know where he compiled this hadith or mentioned this hadith? In the longest verse in the Quran. What is the longest verse in the Quran? أطول آية في القرآن آية الدين يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا تداينتم بدين إلى أجل مسمى فاكتبوه وليكتب بينكم كاتب بالعدل. Basically, Ibn Kathir is telling you that if you want to make a deal with a son of Adam, make sure that you write it down and you have two witnesses. You have two witnesses. Because that person may end up forgetting. With this, brothers and sisters in Islam, Adam عليه السلام came into existence. He is now ready to go, as we say. But there is always a question that people ask, but they ask it the wrong way. And they say, why did Allah create Adam? Why did Allah create Satan? Why did Allah make Adam go through all of this? Number one, that word, why, once you speak about Allah. لا يسأل عما يفعل وهم يسألون. Allah is never to be asked why. But you say, What is the wisdom? What is the wisdom? Remember, one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Hakim, the all-wise. There is always a wisdom behind anything that Allah does, behind anything that Allah says. We just don't get it because our wisdom, brothers and sisters in Islam, is so little compared with the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The question is, what is the wisdom behind the creation of Adam? And the wisdom is to be tested. Adam is to be tested. And you know who will be the tool that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala already showed us in the Quran? The tool of testing for Adam is Iblis, is Satan. When Adam is going through the process of creation, Satan, remember, until this very time, the special creation of Allah, he was a jinni in earth, and then he was elevated to the heavens to be seated with the angels. But yet, that righteousness and piety that he had developed inside him, arrogance and pride, and envy began to also erupt into his heart towards Adam. Now, Adam was created for that purpose, to test Satan and to get out his envy and arrogance, because so far it was still inside his chest. And remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who knows what's inside the chests. Now, the question that we will answer, inshallah, the next episode. What is the wisdom behind all of this? And the next episode, brothers and sisters in Islam, is so important. And inshallah, it will be called a lifetime of testing. The wisdom why we were all created. The wisdom why Satan is here. Let's talk about this, the next episode of The Best of Stories. Till then, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
There is only one God, la ilaha illallah. Lord above the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what and why. There is only one God, la ilaha illallah. I've seen the perfection of all creation in every creature and leaf. And I don't understand any woman or man who denies the one true belief. There is only one God, la ilaha illallah.